So this is day two of Comic-Con, and that's my phone going off. And I'm in much better spirits today. Today started off kind of crappy. And for those of you who don't like these videos, I don't blame you. They're not at all what I anticipated. I thought they'd be a lot more fun, a lot more energetic, but they're not. I'm back at my hotel a lot earlier than I was yesterday, so I can be a lot more louder. I can be a lot more of me and not to worry about scaring my neighbors, because last night I think I filmed it at midnight. I was being quiet.
My hair's
not looking too bad. I mean, it's a little ruffled. Not bad. Today was a lot better. The day started off kind of crappy. And yes, this is going to be a recap of just my day. I have no footage shot today at all. So if you're in this for Comic-Con footage, that kind of stuff, you're going to be pretty much out of luck. Sorry. So my day started off, I woke up at about 8 o'clock, I think, 8 o'clock, maybe 9, and the day started off really bad. First of all, I found out that I probably could not make it to the Venture Brothers autograph session because, first of all, I could not find where it was. I saw one quote on the Comic-Con page that said room 1E07. I couldn't find where that was. I eventually found on there, the way it's worked out, and it would make more sense if I had a map, which my book is somewhere. I have it packed away somewhere. But there is, like, an E area that I think was where it was. But if you look on the Venture Brothers blog, it said they would be at the Entertainment Earth booth, which I saw. But I was like, oh, so there's conflicting things. And they also said there would be Todd McFarlane signing there and Penn Ward from Adventure Time. I was like, that'd be cool, but I could not find anything about him signing at all. But if you go on their convention page of the Venture Brothers blog, it said room 1E07. So I was like, oh, okay. And I thought, sorry, there's something in my camera. I think, I don't know what it is, but this tripod is very, very flimsy. It's not made for cameras. It's made for flashlights. That's how cheap I am. But so I looked on Facebook randomly. My internet connection has this stable enough to go on Facebook. And there was a post by Comic-Con saying notification updates for autographs. What I didn't know was that while the autograph signing was at 1, you had to go in line to get tickets for it at 10:30. And it was already like 8 o'clock-ish. I would have had to shower, caught the shuttle at 9, and gotten there right at 10. Like, I would have had to have been in line a lot earlier than that, because I had a feeling there would be a huge line. Toss my gun before it gets all cruddy. So I had to face it that I would not be able to get an autograph by Doc Hammer and Jackson Publick, which means the two wall scrolls that I bought for me and a friend are, while nice for display, it's the Green Lantern panel that I'm not at, which I'll get to, but which means those wall scrolls I got are basically just for decoration, which they are nice looking. I'm glad I got the ones that I did because they're almost a full cast picture. I may try to track one down that I have. And actually, hang on one second. It was actually a pain to track one down. I didn't know I was going to Comic-Con until like a week or two before the actual convention. But this is the wall scroll I picked up. I got two of this for me and a friend. And you can see it. It's a nice, almost all cast image, which it's nice. I like it. It's got some alternate versions. Like, there's two versions, maybe even three, of Rusty Venture. Brock is in a weird look. Like, I don't know what the premise of this is. I think it's from an episode that I've forgotten. But this will look nice on the wall. It's just I wanted it to be autographed. And I bought one for a friend to be autographed. So I was kind of bummed that I couldn't do that. But since I wasn't going to go for the Venture Brothers autograph session at 1, I was like, well, so if I do go for the Arkham City panel at 12, I would have until 1:15, until 4:15 when the Venture Brothers panel, of a gap of nothing to do. I was like, well, Arkham City, it comes out Tuesday. What are they going to reveal? Like, we learned the Mad Hatter is going to be in it at some point last week. What are they going to reveal from the game? And that is important enough to go to a panel for. So I decided not to go to that, and I relaxed. I wasn't feeling very well. Like, my stomach acts up quite a bit, especially in the mornings. It's bad. That's why I have ginger pills. That's why I have, like, stuff next to my bed that I can take as soon as I wake up, because whenever I wake up from sleeping, I feel horrible, and I don't know why. I can't figure out why. I cannot find anything to tell me why that is. It's just the way it is. It's the way it's been for the past 2 years. Personal insight into my life. So, I was like, okay, well, I'm not going there until 4, at least, for the panel. I was going to meet up with a friend of mine, Rachel, a.k.a. Flame War, a.k.a. Nitro Streak, a.k.a. whatever other name she has on Twitter. Meet up with her and meet up with Callie, who makes the Puggles. And they were there at noon or 1. I think maybe a little earlier. So I eventually got there at 2. I arrived at 2 o'clock, met up with them. Really cool to meet them. I've known Rachel for a while. She actually lives in Zimbabwe, too. So it's kind of weird. We've never met, even though we live in Zimbabwe, yet we meet at New York. So that was interesting. Callie was very nice, very friendly. It was nice to meet her, see the woman behind the Puggles. And just walked around the booths. Like, my problem yesterday is I didn't know what to expect. I was really overwhelmed. I wanted to film everything. And to do that, I didn't focus on things very long. I was trying to get everything I could in a short amount of time, so I really couldn't focus on stuff, unless it really caught my eye, like the Voltron. Voltron caught my eye, and I was... I'm so popular today. I'm so popular. So, walked around the booths, got to check out some things, had some laughs. I took, if you noticed in, I think, the part one video, I had a sonic screwdriver here. Someone wrote, I'm glad I'm not the only one who takes my sonic screwdriver wherever I go. Well, I took mine because Rachel was going as Amy from Doctor Who, so I had a screwdriver she could play with. And she was sonicking everybody she saw, everything she saw, every toy, scanning it, and it was rather, rather hilarious. But did that, I did pick up some things. My main goal today was to pick up 3 things. One, the Arkham City... exclusive of the Joker, Sick Joker, as he's being called by Graffiti Designs, I think. I think they're the same guys who did the White Lantern Hal Jordan and the White Lantern Sinestro. I could be wrong. For Optobotomus, he wanted 2 of those. And Bluefin Distribution had a booth, and I'm going to pronounce this wrong. Tamashii Nations, I think. Yeah, there. I really wanted to check out their booth because I went yesterday and they had a bunch of Gundams, a bunch of Figuarts. I forgot to film the Godzilla display again. If you've seen online, it's been at other conventions. It's the setup where it's Space Godzilla versus Godzilla and Mogira. And then they had another one that's Godzilla versus Mechagodzilla. Really nice displays, like... really nice displays. They really sell the toys. But my main goal was to check out and see if they had the Figuarts Gohan, because I have Goku and Piccolo. I need Gohan. The Rockman X white version, his ultimate form, and something I saw yesterday that I could not get because they weren't selling yet when I was there. I've wanted this for a long time, and for me a long time is potentially a year. I don't know when this originally came out, but I saw a picture of it online. I fell in love with it. I got a Bear Guy, which is basically a Gundam model kit. Like, it's made by Bandai. It's got a Gundam on it, but it's of this bear. He's got a backpack with a rocket launcher built in, or like a missile bay inside of it. I've wanted one of these for so long. $23, which... I think I could have maybe gotten it from, like, Hobby Link Japan, maybe, but I would have been paying shipping on it as well. I finally have one. I was quite happy. And while I was there, I was at checkout, and I saw they did have Rockman X. So now I have his original form, Zero, and the ultimate form. So you may be getting reviews of those in the near future. And that's pretty much all I did after I got those. I had to track down the Graffiti Designs booth, and on my way out, I was trying to find where it was. Like, the problem with Comic-Con for me is, I have actually a map here. Before I went, it was really cool. You can actually go on their website and find the sellers you want to check out, and the green ones are the sellers I wanted to look at. So I had this map, excuse me, And I was using that map, and it's got, you know, marked who I want to see. So I was trying to figure out where graffiti was. This is how big the actual show floor is, to give you an idea. Like, those little teeny tiny booths were like 9x9, 8x8-ish. Massive. But I eventually did find the graffiti designs booth. Got in line to get the Jokers. And there's a sign when you get there that says you cannot pick up their exclusives without a wristband. And you can pick up their wristband on level 1B, show floor B. I don't know 1B. I don't know where that was. And I didn't know where to go. So I'm going to try again tomorrow and pick it up. But yeah, it was a lot better. I think I skipped a lot of my morning. My Zoom died this morning. That was one thing I meant to talk about. Yeah, I woke up, I was feeling sick, and just bleh, and my Zoom started chirping, beeping. The hard drive was whirring. And then I got this little message, contact support, which I looked online, and apparently means there's a problem with the hard drive, which is not good, because this is basically a hard drive. I rebooted it, and it said, please wait for about 20 minutes before it finally shut down. The hard drive, the battery, or, well, the Zoom itself was getting pretty hot. So I don't know what's wrong with it. I really like my Zoom. I really do. And I really like the etching I have on the back of it. Like, that's one thing I could not get with iPod, was this etching. And I really do like that. I picked that out especially. And I thought it was neat. It's like Zoom. So that died, which meant I would not have any form of entertainment aside from my book that I brought, going to the train station, catching my train, any waiting time at the convention, and then train back home, which this was a lifesaver yesterday. If I didn't have this, I would have gone insane. But getting back was easy. Like, I went outside. I knew where to go this time. The problem yesterday was I didn't know my way around. So I walked probably 2 or 3 times more than I should have, because I didn't know where I was going. I was learning. I'd ask someone this, they'd put me over in this direction. Yeah, see, it's still doing it. I'd ask someone else, they'd send me that direction. I was lost, but Sam knew where to go. And, you know, my feet are a little sore, but if you're walking that much, it's expected you're gonna have some sore feet. I feel good. Like, I would have stayed longer. Oh, that's one thing. So after Rachel and Callie left, I was going to go to the Venture Brothers panel at 4. See, I'm jumping around through my day. Jumping around. This is what happens when I'm not focused, when I'm more energetic. When you have Calm Me, who's trying to be quiet at midnight, you're going to get a story. If it's me when I'm being me, it's all over the place. It's like a New York taxi cab going all over the place. But I was going to go to the panel, and I got right above the actual IGN theater lobby. And I did shoot a little bit of footage. I did lie. I got a little bit of footage. This is what I saw waiting to go into the IGN theater, which the next panel would have been the Venture Brothers panel. That is a lot of people. Like I said, there were 100,000 people that are going to Comic-Con this weekend. I don't know how many are down there, but I don't care who the panel is for. I'm not going to stand in a line that long. Like, this was still half an hour before the panel was to start, maybe even 45 minutes. I don't care who it is. I don't want to stand in a line that long just to sit in a panel that, honestly, I could probably watch online when it's uploaded. So I decided not to go to that. And after that was the All Access Green Lantern, which is going on as I'm filming this. I didn't really care to go to that because I didn't know what it would be about. And then at 7:45 is the Transformers MMO panel exhibition. I'm not covering anything game-wise at the convention because, honestly, you know, it's just, I don't care. I really don't. Like, I'm not interested in the game unless it's like Arkham City where it sucks me in instantly and then I want it when it comes out. The Transformers MMO, I'm probably not going to play it, probably not going to do anything with it, so I really didn't care. So I decided to come on back to the hotel. Caught the shuttle was there when I was ready to go. Caught my train. Had a nice guy on the train. I'm really surprised. I had this impression that New Yorkers were, for the most part, kind of rude. Not really rude, just keep to themselves, go where they're going, that kind of thing. I think every train ride I've had, if I've sat next to someone, they've been friendly. We would talk about things. This woman on the shuttle going to the train station was really friendly. We talked about things. She has a son my age. He's into comics and toys, that kind of stuff. So we talked about things. The train on the way back, just a really friendly guy. We talked about phones, you know, the convention. Just really friendly people. I was really surprised. And the shuttle driver, fantastic guy. Fantastic. Really, really all around fantastic. I could say that so many times. But I got off the train, and yesterday, when I caught the train back at Penn or at Secaucus Station, because I'm staying in New Jersey, I went the opposite direction entirely. Like, the train would probably get off here, let's say. You can take an escalator here that goes up, is at the main lobby. There's an elevator that takes you to the street level. And then you're good to go. You're done. You're at the front entrance where taxis and shuttles pick you up. Yesterday, I got off probably about here. I took stairs that went up this way and then came around this way. They went around that way. And I basically walked all the way back here to get to the elevator that took me down to the street back there. That was a pain. That really was. But I got there. I was sitting there, and the only downside is the shuttle runs every hour. So I think I was half an hour or 45 minutes early for the shuttle, but apparently he was running late due to the weather. So he showed up almost right when I sat down. So that was awesome, and I was the only one on the shuttle. So we talked a bit, talked about things, dropped me off, and here I am. I'm probably gonna order dinner soon. Like, I'm really in a good mood right now. Considering my Zune is dead, considering how I felt this morning, I feel great. And it's a good feeling, because when I was supposed to head up here, I was estimating that I would spend $30 going to the convention and then $30 going back. If you count toll roads, it's probably more like $50 total. So I would have spent $100 going to and from the convention, taking the shuttle and the train, and then even just a cab to the convention, I'm spending $15 a day total. Total. That's such a good feeling. It really is. Like, I was honestly prepared to spend $200 in just travel to and from the convention by cab. Because I'm not used to this kind of stuff. I'm not used to shuttles and trains. Like, I've never ridden a train before until coming here. And so I'm really upbeat, because $200 would have been low. It would have probably been close to $300, maybe even $400 for just travel. But I'm spending $8 for a round-trip ticket on the train, $7 for a cab to the convention, and then the shuttle from the convention and then to my hotel are free. So I'm in a good mood. Last night, I ordered steak, because I was like, you know what? I'm saving money on travel. I'm going to treat myself to some room service, and I had me a steak, and it was delicious. I think I may have some quesadillas tonight, because they're good, and they're cheap, too. So, yeah. My plans tomorrow, I have not met anybody from Comic-Con yet. So, if you have not seen me there, if you want to meet me at Comic-Con, send me a message. And I'll try to figure out a place where you can meet up. Like, I don't know who really wants to meet me. Apparently, some of you do want to meet me. If you do want to say hi, send me a message either on Twitter or YouTube and try to figure something out. Tomorrow, I'm not sure how much I'm going to be there. There's someone shooting things. The filmmaker I mentioned yesterday, Jesse, he's shooting things, and since I'm probably not going to any panels at all this weekend, I may just show up, say hey to Rachel and Callie, and then go off and help him with whatever he needs done shooting there. That's what I may do tomorrow. And then tomorrow night, I have a friend visiting, a surprise friend that you guys actually know in a way, and should be fun. So that's it for tomorrow, and this is it for my thing today, unless there's some update I have to do later on. But I'm going to probably order dinner. It's 5:16. Probably order dinner in about half an hour, maybe an hour. And I may open him up. And I'm tempted to open Bear Guy, but I may wait until I'm back home. If I can. I don't know. I'm tempted to shoot a video on these guys, but I don't have really good lighting, so it probably wouldn't be that great, but you may see something. I do have a video already filmed for Stormbomb, Fans Project Insecticon 2. So I have to edit that, and maybe I'll get that uploaded today. I may honestly play some Deus Ex while I'm here. I may. I'm in a good enough mood. I may. I don't know. See how much happy I am? I was miserable this morning. And last night I was kind of beat, but I'm in a good mood. So for those of you who are enjoying these, I'm glad you do. If you don't like them, I'm sorry. You don't have to watch them, but I will talk to you tomorrow, most likely. See ya.